I've gotten quite a few requests for this kit in the comment sections of different videos and Facebook posts, so we will take a look at Lenny Pond's Chevy Malibu from AMT in 1/25th scale today. It is a pretty cool kit of a legendary NASCAR racer. They got a picture of Lenny here and some of his cars. Now, some of the information on this vehicle is hard to track down as far as exact colors and schemes and stuff on the vehicle, so I'm going to build mine based on some pictures I found based on the box art. We're going to go with that. If you want to get down to exact show winning perfect stuff on your vehicle, you will have to research much deeper to find out that information. First up, we'll show off in this kit is the expanded decal sheet. Check that out. We've got a metallic gold tan. We've got the master decals, the 54s, the 427 logos. I mean, we've got everything on there. The only thing I'm not seeing on here is a gauge cluster and tire decals. We've got the Goodyear logos here, but all the stock cars and all that have the big Goodyear logos, and I'm not seeing those decals anywhere on the sheet. So of course you could source those from any other decal sheet that you have or generic, but we've got a lot of nice options on here if you decide to go with that paint scheme. Of course, he also ran a paint scheme that was just the metallic-ish yellow look as well, just the plain without that, so you can replicate that on there. Though the only thing not on there is that long red pinstripe is not on the decal sheet all by itself. In the parts is a chrome tree. These are extremely bright chrome. We'll want to tone that down. I've shown how to do that in the videos for many years, so you'll be able to see that when we go through it. We've got a set of four Goodyear branded tires. They do have quite large logos on the side, so you could trace those out with a white gel pen. I've never been good at that. My hand is steady enough, but I can never find a gel pen or a white acrylic pen that will work. Enamel paint pens will not dry on these vinyl style tires. They are hollow, they have a shallow tread that can be sanded, and they have the branding on both sides, so if you screw up the lettering, you can always try again on the other side. We've got two steel axles. Given the kit's age, steel axles are extremely common and they hold the weight. And then we've got a large windshield, single piece front and back. If you don't like that, if you want to place each piece of glass by itself because you want to do it that way, simply slice these off and you'll be set and ready to go. We've also got, of course, white styrene. We've got a basic interior here, would just be probably bent sheet metal reinforced with the roll cage. You cannot build a stock Malibu from this. That would be absolutely impossible. We've got our body and chassis here. Check out the suspension detail molded in, and then our axle is going to lay across those two perches, so it should sit perfectly straight for you. Our front axle will go through those suspension arms that are molded in place and the sway bar. You can always do a little extra detailing on there, and whatever you decide. I always like to add just a little bit of detail. We've got our roll cage coming up. Extra large bars on here. We can get that painted. They are molded open. I think is that halves of a fire extinguisher on either side like that. We've got a dashboard. You can see the gauges on there are prominent enough. Should be able to use my silver pencil trick. We'll do that in the video to get the detail on those. And all three go pedals. Well, we got the stop, the go, and the let the go out pedal. Got a little tree of wheel backs. Don't lose that. It's loose in the bag. We've got our differential and drive shaft. We've got our taillight blockouts. You can see they've got little rivets on them and everything in the back there. What else we got? We got a good amount of parts in this kit. We've got our radiator, battery, shock absorbers in the rear. Got our spoiler, firewall with actual detail on it. More roll cage parts. On this tree here, we've got the nice slab hood. We saw that that decal was cut open for the vents. We've got a small driver's seat with very, very, very fine belt detail. We've got some other trim pieces. We've got some of these braces that will go from the firewall to the chassis, so we won't be able to use those until final assembly. We'll glue them in place. We got our headlights and the top of the grill right there. On another tree, we've got the wheels, which are molded open, so they definitely cleaned out the mold for that. Steering wheel, exhaust headers with the exhaust dumps coming out, belt and pulley system, distributor, intake, oil pan are all on the sheet there for you. I have no idea what these parts are, so we'll find out what those are when we start gluing them together. And then we've got our engine, block halves and transmission, water pump, even got a starter battery, belt pulley system, looks like our intake there, or our air cleaner. Got another steering wheel option, cylinder heads, valve cover. So actually you're going to have some spare parts with this one. And then we've got that Malibu body that people are going to love making into all different kinds of stock cars. All different kinds of racers will be built off of this. Nicely done. It's got the windshield bracing molded in. Again, you wouldn't be able to build a stock Malibu from this very easily. I mean, it would take an intense amount of work. You can see the nice molding. The door lines are actually in there quite nice, though you could always scratch those open and make them deeper if you wished. Got our bracing on the glass with its little connectors top and bottom. We can highlight that. We got our trunk lid. We've got molded in our trunk pins. Blanked out door handles. So it's all great stuff. The kit looks awesome. I'm going to start gluing it together. I've never had a chance to build this one. This thing is kind of sold out in a lot of places, but I will link in the description. You can get on lists to get it, and one of the places in the description still has it in stock. Let's take a look at what we got going on with Lenny Pond's ride. Now, the roll cage does not secure into the car in any specific place on in the interior. So what I did was I kind of laid it on there. I built it off the board and then laid it in and readjusted everything off camera while all the glue was setting up to make sure that it sat in there square and was even with the front side to side and that the rods light up in the back and the diagonal rods all line up inside. It's not the most perfect job, but I don't worry about perfection on any of this stuff. I just want you guys to see what's in the kit, how it builds up. So the roll cage is one piece. Now on the interwebs, all the supposed experts out there, the self-proclaimed experts, half the group claims that the interior of the car that they personally claim to have seen is like a trunk splatter gray look. The other group claims that the body color is what was used on the interior as well. So once again, completely up to you, the modeler, to build what you want, how you want it to look. I will decide how I want my interior and roll cage to come out on my car, and then I will duplicate as much as I can the box art shades, and a couple of the pictures on the internet which show this as almost a yellow metallic kind of a rich gold metallic kind of a look. I'm going to try to replicate that, and then we'll put the decals on it and stuff like that. We'll make it look as cool as we can. So the body's got the front and the back glued on. I made sure that you can still fit the chassis in, and you can, so it won't be an issue to attach it now and paint it all together. And then what I do is I glue parts on like this, and like the roll cage, I use model glue to start melting the parts together like a real weld, and then I use super glue to sort of tack weld it, hold it in place, and let the model glue finish its work. So that's how that's going to look, front and back. Nice seams on there. If you wanted it absolutely perfect, you would just have to take those seams out with some putty, but like we can see on the box art and on the real cars, there is a seam there right along that line, right behind that red stripe, you can see a seam. So you really shouldn't try to eliminate that completely. It almost disappeared with the glue. Otherwise, we just left it on there. It looks pretty cool. So we got the body all set to go. The interior, I just glued the firewall on. And we can go with that as is. We can get that painted up. I glued the radiator and its ducting, its shroud that they call it. We got the back part on. We got the top part on. Just line that all up. And then that will drop in like so when we go to glue it on the car when we're all done and ready to put the engine in and whatnot. The chassis itself didn't take any work, but I did use the chassis to build the rear suspension just so that I could make sure everything lined up and sits in there the way it should. Then we can get this painted separately. We can detail it. We can paint the four shock absorbers and all that and get that all painted up. The dashboard was just cut and placed on its own tree. I glued the belt and pulley system together. Once I get that primed black with the exhaust system, then I will cut that free and then paint the exhaust the color that I want it to be. We've got our air cleaner and our battery, so we'll get those primed. Then I'll remove the battery and paint the air cleaner the color that I want it to be. These front bars to the chassis will actually, when the car's all together, this is going to go like so. This is going to drop in here. And then these bars going forward like this will end up going like this and kind of going over the fenders to reinforce the front of the car. That's the way the instructions show it. Just to clarify, in case you're wondering, where do we got that picture? There. Two firewall, two chassis. You can see where it has that part bending over like that. And that's how we have to do it after the car is together. So that's, we'll set up that. We'll get that off to the side. Got the fire extinguisher glued together. Got the cooler here glued together. Goes on the interior. Got our racing steering wheel. Our seat. Our exhaust pipes. Those are ready to go. Got the wheels glued together. Since we can easily push those soft Goodyear tires over the top, we've got those all glued together. The hood and the spoiler are ready to go. Those are all set. And then we've got our engine. I glued the intake on. I didn't want it a bright chrome like that. I'll paint it by hand. Got our coil and our distributor. Got our little oil filter. Got our chrome oil pan on there and our starter. It's a nice looking engine. It definitely does the part for that engine. It's nothing spectacular, and it has to have a big hole through the block to fit that metal wire through for the front axle. It's a very common thing to do in the models that day with the technology, the way they wanted it to set up, and the way they wanted the models to roll. A lot of these were built by kids that wanted to push them on the floor, or roll them around on the shelves, or rotate the tires, so we have to make caveats for that. So anyways, I'm going to get everything start to put together. I'm going to get it over in the paint area. I'm going to try to get a close color to what I've seen on the car, and I'll see you over there. Time for the look-see. Now I did this one a little different since the body's going to go on to the chassis pretty easy. It's not going to be a tight fit or a bang fit or anything. I usually like to put my decals on as the very last thing and then clear coat them. This time I put the decals on just so I could add that part in the video. I've done it dozens and dozens of times, but figured this one we haven't done a longer decal application part in a while, so I put on all the big decals. I did not use a drop of decal solvent during the entire time. And what I discovered on these decals, you'll want to watch yours just to make sure. As it dried, the top edge of that brown tan trim started to curl down. That's got a little red pinstripe inked all the way around it. And it started to curl down. So when it started to curl, that's when I got out the decal solvent, ran it along the top edge on the front and the back where it was starting to pull away from the car, and that made it lay back down flat. So you might not need it, you might need it. It all depends on what the temperature's like in your shop, what's going on, but otherwise they lay down, they look real nice, and they look sharp. I definitely wanted to use them on mine so you could see what they would look like. We've got them all the way around. Got them on the headlight covers, got them on the hood, got it on the roof. The glass just presses in from the bottom, and I use super glue to hold it in along those long spars that go between the glass. I didn't, use Mod Podge or anything, and that looks lovely. The only thing that took some time is all the contingency decals are individual. They don't have them in clumps or anything, so we did put those on individually. But yeah, that looks great. Number 54 looks tough, looks neat, got the Malibu shape. We got the grill done. You saw me go over it with that off black, that NATO black from Tamiya, and then I dry brushed it with a silver to kind of give it that, on the box art and stuff in the real world, it's kind of that mesh on the front, but that'd be really hard to do with a black wash in there because it's so shallow. So I just painted it black, gave it a dry brush, and that'll look cool enough on the front of the car. It'll look like a radiator. And in the rear bumper, as you've known me for years to do, I spray my chrome with a matte clear, and then if I need to, I'll go over it with a Tamiya black wash. This one I just did some paint on it, and we got it going that way. So that's how we get those bumpers to tone down quite a bit for something that would have been run on the racetrack. The interior is all set. What I did for those front bars, those are just glued on with some super glue and then black washed at the joint, so it looks kind of like a weld or like a hole going through the firewall. I took the interior, I set it on the frame, and then I glued those front pieces on just in the back. And that's how I got that roll cage assembly to assemble all the way through. We got our fire extinguisher in a bright red. We got our differential cooler. We got our gauges done. You saw how I did that with the silver pencil. And then we got our seat in there. Did it with the yellow belts to match the car. And I left all the roll cage a primer gray like a lot of them were done. So I just, that one guy couple people had said it was just a plain gray interior, and that's what I left it as, and it doesn't matter. Since I don't take this to a show, I don't have to worry about that. This is just an assembly review, not how to make the world's most perfect Lenny Pond Malibu. We got the 427 under the hood, got the air cleaner on. That is the air cleaner that the manual says to use, so I just went with it for the review. That's how I did it. I did it up in the Chevy orange, since that's the color it was on the box. Got our headers in place. The headers install from the bottom after the engine is in place, and they install quite easily and mount up very nice. I used thick super glue to just hold them on there. I pretty much painted the engine to match the box art. I liked the box art. I thought it looked good. 427, did it in the engine orange, and then I did the transmission in just a combo of colors in a gold and a silver, so that we draw a little bit of attention to that. Underneath, we got our exhaust pipes coming out either side. The wires fit into the wheels beautifully. The tires are a little big for the wheels, so you may have some issues with the tires continuously popping off the wheels. I get them to hold on, then when I have to put the body on, I'm sure I'm going to knock them loose again and have to reattach them. If you're not going to be moving the car around a lot, you probably won't have an issue. If it's going to be a shelf sitter like mine, or eventually mine will go into a box and get stored. But yeah, so that's fine. We got the radiator mounted in the front, got the radiator hose, got the fan and everything mounted up. Very easy to install all of that stuff. And then I just did the dry brush on the bottom. So that's it for the car. I've just got to put the interior on, stretch the body over the top, and then glue my bumpers on front and rear. I'll come back when I do that for the final reveal. A lot of folks will be happy that the Lenny Pond 125th Malibu stock car from AMT is back and available with a cool expanded decal sheet allowing you to do two different types of cars, either just the full yellowish car or the yellow and brown trimmed car. I decided to go with the full decal option just so you guys could see how those go on and see what they're going to look like. Experimented with some paint on this thing. There are some things I want to go over during final assembly that I had to work on to get the hood to sit down as far as I could get it, and to get the fenders to sit as far up in the front of the car without making it look like it was dragging its tail like a dog with worms, I had to remove some material from the top of the radiator. In fact, I would recommend building the car without that upper lip on the radiator that you saw me assemble in the assembly section. When you take the radiator and then you glue in the secondary, the radiator core on that brace, if you eliminate that entire upper, they call it like an air duct that matches the shape of the hood underneath, you won't have to eliminate any material from the top of the radiator when you bring your car together, and it doesn't help hold the hood up or anything. It was just like a little air duct in there. I eliminated it completely, and I trimmed that down and then painted over it with black so you really wouldn't notice it too much, and it still looks completely fine under the hood, as you'll see in the pictures. And then I was able to get the nose down far enough, glue it to that radiator support, and then I was able to get the hood to sit down all the way. Otherwise, before that, the nose sat quite high, very high, and even trying to pull it down and glue it, the car just didn't look right to me. So I eliminated that piece, cut it off, and glued everything back down, and then I didn't have any issues with the way it fit together. So, and then of course the last thing I talked about was, again, putting the body on. The tires popped off the wheels like three or four times on two different wheels on different ends, so I eventually got them slid back on and they are holding, so we should be good for the rest of the model's life. You could always glue them from the inside and have them hold that way if you wanted a super tight fit. The kit itself builds quite easy, minus that fit issue and the tires on the wheels. If you're gonna big issues to complain about a kit, this isn't the one. It goes together just fine. Those are some suggestions. Maybe I misaligned something. Maybe when you assemble yours, you won't even need to remove any material from the top of the radiator mount, but I'll let you know what I encountered on the way there. Also, before the final came, I did lose one decal. I lost the little cardinal on the pillar. It's on the other side. I must have brushed it off, and it must have just disappeared into the carpet monster. I'm not sure, but you can see it on this side. The other side, it completely disappeared, and there's only two of those in the kit. They go right up there on that pillar there on the box art. So, fun kit. I've never built a Malibu stock car before. I didn't even know they existed. So I learned something new with this review. In fact, I did a little Googling on Lenny Pond to find out who he was. I do enjoy NASCAR, but I'm not an expert on every single guy that's ever run around the track. I liked it. My experiment with the paint went okay. I would probably try to find a more metallic color like I saw online, or a deeper yellow, but I think it looks all right the way it is now with my little experiment with the pearl yellow and stuff like that when I was trying it out. So you can see that in the painting section. The kit goes together fine. It's got plenty of detail. It is not a modern NASCAR kit, so you're not going to find that extreme, you know, in a 2020s model detail, but it is a nice kit and it builds up, and plenty of you can buy this car just for the body and the decals and the grill and the bumper, the spoiler, the headlight blackouts, and you can install that onto most modern NASCAR model chassis. As always, I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. It's a fun, quick build. Got it done in 2 days. Total of maybe 10 hours invested in the kit over those 2 days, not including dry time for decals and all that. Enjoyed it. Was not struggling with anything when I had to trim that radiator material. It was not a fight. It was just a straight across trim. I usually use my side nippers, my larger ones, and I can trim straight across and get the work done pretty easy, and then just paint over it with whatever color I had, which is to be expected with older model kits, as you'll have to do some custom fitting. Again, thanks for watching reviews. Build your models for you. Show me if you build a different style of stock car out of this Malibu body on the Facebook page. I'd be interested in seeing it, and we will see all of you at the next review.